If you've been confused about how to use the CRM inside of ActiveCampaign, this video is for you. I'm Karanda Adair, CEO of Carvel Digital and certified automation service provider. In this video, I'm going to break down what a CRM is and some of the best ways to use it inside of ActiveCampaign. Let's get into it. All right, let's start with defining what is a CRM. CRM stands for Customer Relationship Manager, and it's used to efficiently store and organize all of the relevant information about your contacts that are going to help you with your marketing and your sales. Now, one of the important things that makes it a CRM and not just a database is the ability to message your contacts based on information or data that you learn and store about them, or events that happen, or behaviors that your contacts are doing that you may be tracking. So if you can't message your contacts from your CRM without physically going in and maybe doing something manual, like clicking through to a social media platform or clicking through to your email provider, then it's not a true CRM. You need to be able to do those things automatically, because the whole point is for us to save time and start letting the robots take over some of these manual tasks from you and your team. You can use a CRM for both marketing and sales, which are two different processes, and you can use a CRM for B2C, business to consumer marketing and sales, and B2B, business to business marketing and sales. Your CRM serves as your second brain by storing all the things that you need to remember to further the relationship with your contacts. And the longer your sales cycle, the more you need a CRM. So are you a B2C or a B2B business? And how long is your sales cycle? How long before someone comes into your world until they actually buy from you, generally speaking? Let me know in the comments. One thing many people don't know is that it's actually pretty common to have a marketing CRM versus a client CRM. Your client CRM, especially if you're in an industry that's regulated, might be something that's a little more proprietary software. You might need a little bit better security to keep your client data safe. So it's totally fine to have a marketing CRM, and then once that person becomes a client, you pass that into your client CRM. ActiveCampaign includes a really powerful way to store all of your contact data, your communication history, notes about your interactions with people, so that you and your whole team can keep track of all of those details as you move towards the sale. Let's look at some examples of how you can utilize your CRM for marketing, sales, delivery, and automation. One of the most important features in the CRM is going to be custom fields. Custom fields is where you can store all of the data that you want to know and remember about your contacts. And ActiveCampaign has some custom fields that are there by default, but you can create any kind of custom field that you like. You can store lots of different kinds of data in there, text fields, numbers, dates, and you can create groups so that you can group your custom fields together in a way that makes sense to you. One of the nice things about custom fields is that you can actually use the data inside of it in your emails by using the variables. If we look at this contact, you can see the most recent lead magnet is the guide to alien detection technology. So let's say we want to send an email where we deliver that guide as soon as someone opts in. In your email, you can now use a variable that's provided by ActiveCampaign, and you get to it with this personalized tag, and then you just search for the variable that you're looking for. And now when this goes out in email, it's actually going to spit out the value of whatever is stored in that field. So that's really cool. And it's going to allow you to personalize your marketing. And when you personalize and you're more relevant, that's going to increase your conversions. On the sales side, ActiveCampaign has a feature called Deals, and this allows you to track your sales pipeline. So you can create your pipeline to mirror your sales process, and then you can move people or companies through your sales process, your pipeline, manually or automatically. One of the great things about deals is that it allows you to track one-to-many relationships. So if we look at this Star Labs contract deal, you can see that the company that we're dealing with is Team Flash, and maybe there's more than one person at this company that you're communicating with about this deal. So let's say we wanted to add another contact to this deal. So we can add contact, do a search, and now you can have as many people as you need to track connected to this company. You can add value to each deal so that at any time you know how much potential revenue is in your pipeline, which will motivate you to follow up with your people. And if you have a team, there's space down here to write notes about every interaction that you have with this company or any of the leads inside this company so that anyone on your team can track the history of your communications with this client or potential client. A really great thing to do is to connect your email address to ActiveCampaign. And when you do that, it's going to bring in any emails that you exchange with this person. And it doesn't matter if it's a subscriber email that's sent from ActiveCampaign or just a regular email that you logged into your Gmail or your Outlook client and had some communication back and forth. It's going to bring all that communication in so that it's part of the history so that everyone on your team can see it. Now let's talk about how deals can be really useful for tracking your customer journey post-sale. The deals feature is really just a pipeline. And so anytime that you want to track progress through a process, you can create a pipeline for that. One of the things that we do in our business is we have a pipeline for the customer journey through our content bootcamp. So I will just create a pipeline that has week one, week two, and then we'll move people through that process. So at any time we can come in here and we can see which exact week people are in the program and we can follow up with them accordingly. If you had a course, you could use deals to track progress through your course and then you can see where people get stuck. And then you can use automations to send them follow-up emails and encourage them to get back into the course and continue making progress. One of the best things about having all of this information in one place is that there are so many opportunities to automate parts of this process. So let's look at some examples. So let's say in your sales pipeline, there's a stage where you're waiting on someone to sign the proposal. So we can add that stage and ActiveCampaign knows how long someone's been in a certain stage. So you could make an automation that says, if someone is in this stage for more than 7 days, then we're going to send them a follow-up email. On the customer side, you could store your customer lifetime value in a field, and you could have an automation and an integration that every time someone buys another product from you, you could go and you could add to that lifetime value. So then you could say, hey, when this lifetime value reaches a certain amount, say $10,000, we're going to trigger a notification to the team to send out some kind of personalized thank you to enhance the client experience, to thank them for their business, and to just deepen that relationship and make it more likely that they'll continue to buy from you. Another way that we use automation in our client journey is we have a pipeline that just tracks where people are in our program for content bootcamp, but we don't want our team members to have to come in here every week and move people through these pipelines. So we set up an automation and it's triggered by someone being added to that pipeline. And then we send a welcome email and then we just use the wait feature inside this automation to wait for a week and then automatically move people through that pipeline. And the nice thing about that is because it's an automation, you can also send emails. So we might have check-in emails at, you know, the second week, the third week, the sixth week. Another thing that we do is we use a custom field to collect the wins that our clients share with us as they go through our program. Now, because it's in a custom field, when they get to a certain point in the program, we can now send them an email and we can use that variable to display all the wins that they've shared with us as they're coming through our program. And it keeps them motivated to keep taking action and keep moving towards their goals. So that's one example of how you could really enhance your customer journey for your clients who've already paid you. And make it more likely that they'll stay on with you for longer. One thing that's going to enhance all of these things is when you integrate with other tools that you're using in your business. So for instance, ActiveCampaign has a native integration with Calendly. And if you use Calendly to allow people to schedule appointments with you, that information can go directly, automatically onto their contact record. So you can see the history of all the appointments that you've had with that person. So now we looked at CRM features for the marketing journey, the sales journey, and the client journey, and all of these are systems that we set up for our clients every single week. I hope this has demystified the CRM for you and that you're getting lots of ideas on how you can use this inside your business. If you found this useful and you want to know more, sign up for my free resource, Hidden Gems of ActiveCampaign, by going to carveldigital.com/gems. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up and comment down below and let me know how you're going to start using the CRM in your business. I'll see you in the next video.